إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. وبعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى in the Quran in سورة الفجر says in the very end of the surah, calling upon a human being characterized by an inner state. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي. يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة. Tranquil soul, tranquil nafs, a heart which is mutma'in, a nafs that's mutma'inna. Allah calls about a human being that's characterized by an inner state. An inner state of what? Peace, equilibrium, serenity, balance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon such a state of a human being. A human being characterized by a nafs mutma'inna. A self, a heart that's tranquil, peaceful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, irji'i ila rabbik, you return back to your Lord. Content, happy. Your Lord and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with you, and you are happy and content with your Lord. And as such, fadkhuli fi ibadi, come among the best honor, to be among my ibad, the ones that worship me, the ones that serve only me. And those that serve Allah, the universe serve them. Those who focus on Allah, the universe runs after them. And those who run after the universe runs away from them, and their hearts gets dispersed. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَادْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَادْخُلِي جَنَّتِي, and enter my paradise. And subhanallah, what I want to be speaking about today is that state of an inner self, a nafs mutma'inna, a peaceful peace that's inside. See, most of us don't realize this. We think peace comes from outside. That the only way for me to be happy, content, peaceful, at equilibrium, tranquil, has to do with everything around me. If there is chaos around, if there are people that annoy me around, I'm not at peace. It's the opposite. Peace emerges inwardly. Like the one that when they threw him in prison, the great scholar, and things were difficult for him, and he said, مَا يَفْعَلُ أَعْدَائِي بِي? What can my enemies do to me? جَنَّتِي فِي صَدْرِي. My paradise is in my chest. أينما ذهبت فهي معي. Wherever I go, whatever happens, it's with me. Can I be this way? This inner state of a nafs, a self, that's mutma'in, that is tranquil, that, if you will, is balanced. And there is a dua. This dua, one of my duas that I like personally, I'll share with you. When in this dua, actually we request this narration, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inni as'aluka nafsan mutma'inna. Oh Allah, I ask something from you, a self that's tranquil, that's peaceful, that's mutma'inna, tarda bi qada'ik, content with whatever decree you provide, whatever happens, is content with you, tarda bi qada'ik, wa taqna' bi ata'ik, sufficed with whatever provision you give, little, few, much, doesn't matter. وَتَرْجُوا لِقَائِكَ, always hopeful, always longing to meet you. That's its drive. And that is what يعني, we seek. A nafs that's a mutma'inna. This is a nafs that is not easily agitated. A nafs that can bear calamities with, if you will, it's like a mountain. Doesn't move. When annoyance happens, delays happens, it is at peace. It's not easily agitated. It's tranquil. I want a nafs like that. How can I get it? How can I have those forces within me balanced? Right? This is what I'm speaking about. And what I'm speaking about can be characterized by one word. What I'm describing, this nafs mutma'inna, I'm asking for one characteristics only. This one, which is what I'm going to be speaking about today. And this characteristic is the answers of many questions that we have. For example, questions that characterizes a self that's not in a state of atminan is what? Questions like the following. Brother, you know what? I can't lower my gaze. Tell me something to do. I have a problem. With the internet websites, whenever I see something that's haram, I can't. I know it's haram, don't tell me it's haram or I know, but I just can't. I can't resist. It's, I can't help it. What can I do? Tell me what to do. How can I be like what you said? How? Another person might say, I'm suffering from lack of steadfastness. You know, one day I decide to pray salat, sunnah salah. I pray for 1, 2, 3 days and then I miss it. One day I wake up for Fajr, 1 week I'm waking up, then the other day I'm not consistent. Ramadan, I was reading Quran every day, but after that, I can't be steadfast. I put hijab, but after a week, I just remove it. I lack steadfast. What can I do? How can I be steadfast? How can I be constant? This constant state of itmainan. How? Right? This is a third question, which is oftentimes we complain about. I complain about lack of khushu'. My mind. I can't concentrate. I can't focus. As a matter of fact, even in this khutbah, you're speaking and my mind now, you're too boring. I'm already out there. I can't focus for half an hour. In salah, 3 minutes. Allahu Akbar, my mind kills me. I don't know what to do. Tell me what to do. How can I attain focus, right? This is the question. How? Be practical, brother. Don't tell me other people did it. How? Right? I'm lacking that. When calamities or tribulation happen in life, oh my God, a prick of a needle can cause me to... I can't take. If something bad happens in my life, I don't know what will happen. Tell me what to do. I become agitated easily. One of my kids dropped some water on my laptop and it's the end of the world. Right? I'm like a volcano waiting to erupt. I'm agitated. What can I do? I need something practical. Okay. Okay, I'll tell you something. This khutbah is about that. What can I do? Alhamdulillah. But before I tell you the answers, I'll tell you what something Imam Al-Ghazali said. Imam Al-Ghazali said the following. المشكلة, he said, النصيحة سهلة. المشكلة في قبولها. Advice telling you is easy. But the problem is, will I do it? If I was to tell you really what to do, the question is not what I say. Are you willing to do it? Oh yeah, of course, tell me about what to do and for khushu' and salah, just spit it out. Right? Say it. And I'll tell you the following. Okay. Okay, we'll begin with something that all of us can do. Do you have a car outside? Yes. Do you drive? Yes. Okay, I want you to drive 10 miles per hour slower than the speed limit in all conditions. Huh? Right. Okay, do you buy things, groceries, Ralph's and Albertson? Yes. Which aisle do you check out from? Yeah, I want you to check out from the longest line, always. Huh? What? I'm speaking about khushu'ah. I'm speaking about not lowering my gaze has nothing. Will you do it? Of course not. But why? Because number one, it has nothing to do with what you just mentioned. And number two, I don't see... What is that? This is ridiculous, right? This has everything to do with what I just discussed. This has everything to do with the quality that we're lacking and is half our faith. What I'm speaking about today, as scholar said, is nusful iman. No, it's not marriage. For young guys, oh, yeah, right? No, nusful iman. Is not marriage. This is what I'm speaking about is not marriage. It is that quality that we're lacking. But I didn't understand what you said. I know. That's why I'll inshallah will try to explain what is the relation and what does that have to do with our deen. Right? The quality we're speaking about. I don't know if you got it or not. I'm asking for one thing. One quality. That's not half of our faith. Patience. As-sabr. If you were to make a classical khutbah about sabr, we'll quote all the ayahs and the virtues. No, I'm not. I'm going to take it from a different angle, inshallah, today. Sabr, patience, yes. Look, when I say, I cannot lower my gaze, what am I saying? I can't be patient. When something is out there and myself, my nafs, there is this shahwa lust, look, hadr, I have to look. I can't be patient. When I say, I'm not steadfast, salah, pray every day, 5 times a day, I can do it for 1 month, but every year till I die, it requires what? Patience. Be patient. Wasbir. Wa'mur ahlaka bis-salah wastabir 'alayha. The Quran says that. Order your family to pray. Have patience over it. There is patience in doing. There is patience in restraining and refraining from doing that which is haram. And there is patience in what? In doing. Right? What about khushu'? What does that have to do with patience? Oh yeah, of course. It has everything to do with lack of patience. See, because we did not define patience correctly. When we say sabr, how does our scholar define it even linguistically? They say sabr huwa al-man' wal-habs, is to restrain, to imprison. Your ability to restrain and hold back. So when I go to salah, Allahu Akbar, what happens? What am I? My mind wanders everywhere. What am I saying? I can't restrain my mind. I can't hold back my mind. My thoughts are not under my control. I can't control them. It wanders every, even now. Even this khutbah, I can't focus on you. My mind is at work. My mind is, did I lose the ability? I can't restrain it. I can't call it back. Can I tell myself, don't think now. It is not the time to think about my job. It's the time to be in the khutbah. Even if it's boring, refrain. I can't. Even thoughts, I cannot control my thoughts. I lack patience, the ability to hold back. That is sabr. And yani, to illustrate it more, scholars said the following. And this is yani, the technical definition yani, of scholars like Ibn al-Qayyim and things like that would explain this for you. They said the following. As-sabr, thabat da'i al-qalb, da'i al-aql wa-d-deen. Amam da'i al-nafs, da'i al-hawa wa-shahwa wa-al-ghadab. So subhanAllah, a very interesting definition. They say the following. The explanation. A human being from inside of me, yani, put it briefly, I'm not one thing. There is a part of me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani, created and I share with animals. The worldly part, the materialistic part, the nafs, the lower self if you will. This is the center of two forces. The force of shahwa, lust, and anger. Animals have that. Animals have lust. They're hungry, they eat. You upset them, they get angry, they attack. A human being has this. We have it. I have a center inside of me, two forces. Shahwa, lust, and anger. Inside. But Allah gave me something that He did not give animals. The spiritual heart. The heart of the human being. That's the center of what? Cognition and will. And they say, Al-Qalbu Ya'qil, as the Quran said, the heart refrains. The heart is the thing that I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will. Consciousness comes from there. They therefore define the following. As-sabr, patience, is when the force of the heart, the force of deen, religion, the force of restrain of the heart is strong enough that it can restrain the forces coming from the nafs, which is what? Lust and anger. A burst of anger comes from me. Somebody did something. Let's revenge. Let's show him who he is. Anger, a burst of anger. If I have sabr, my heart will direct this force towards anger. It will restrain it. That's the birth of a very beautiful khuluq, hilm, forbearance. Lust, eat. You need to eat. You want a chocolate cake. Well, my heart comes, not now. I'm not an animal. I can control it. That's the birth of iffah. I'm afraid. I should speak, but I'm afraid. I'm being a coward, right? But if my heart restrain this fear coming from my nafs, speak. That's courage. Spend. There is a charity box. Spend $1,000. My nafs tells me what? A force comes. No, hold back. Bukhl, shuh. If my heart, patience is what? I restrain that force back. No, spend. That is generosity. Right? The equilibrium, if you will, that we speak about, a nafs that's mutma'inna, is a nafs with balanced forces inside of it. The reason we suffer, those forces are not balanced. Can I tell you something very simple? Many of us complain, when I became religious, actually I'm worse. Inside, I used to be in the past, sometimes when I was not religious, it seemed that, I see it even in many people, they're happy, they're content, you know, they're living life, they're at equilibrium. But when I turn to Allah, it's like a battle raging inside of me. It's worse. Why? I'll tell you why. And Wallahu ta'ala a'lam, I think this is many of us why we suffer. Because, remember what we said, we have two sides, the heart and the nafs. Alhamdulillah, we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we enforce the force of the heart, its ability to restrain. You come and attend the khutbah. We pray. In Ramadan, you pray Taraweeh, you read Quran. You enforce the heart. The force of the heart is stronger. But I go outside of this door and what happens? Backbiting. Watch a movie. Go out and eat too much. Speak too much. I enforce the nafs. The problem with people yani, that turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're enforcing both sides. They're doing things that enforces their heart. But at the same time, without knowing, we're enforcing the forces of the nafs. Now what happens when you do that? You know when you have two sides that are fighting, two enemies, and you give weapons to both sides, what happens? The war rages even more. It becomes more terrible. And you give some weapons to the one side and weapons to the other side. Nobody wins. And I'm consistently inside in turmoil. What I need to do is restrain the nafs, diminish the intake of the nafs in one side. and enforce the heart. This is the path. So sabr, how to attain it? What am I speaking about today? Tell me how, right? What does this have to do with what we said? Look, I'll tell you the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but before that, I'm going to tell you about an experiment that scientists did that might explain it for you. So scientists, and sometimes they do interesting experiments, they got two species of monkeys, a common marmoset and a cottonhead, if you want to know. Two species that are very alike. And they did this experiment. They wanted to experiment with patience. And they defined patience, the ability to hold. The ability to hold back, to restrain, to refrain. Knowing that if you hold back, there is a bigger reward. To delay gratification. One way to put it. And they did this experiment, and they presented the monkeys with some of their food. If they were to eat it, that's it. If they were to be patient, they get a bigger amount of food. One species of monkeys can never wait. You put the food in front of them, there is no patience whatsoever. They eat it, they fight for it. Fight and eat it. The other species, on the other hand, they notice, they wait. They do not eat it. They choose to wait consistently. And therefore, they get more food. And yani, scientists said, why? What is different? The brain size is the same. The two species are almost the same. What is different between the two species? They found one difference. You know what it was? The eating habits. One species of monkeys, they eat bugs. So, to eat bugs means what? You react quickly. A bug comes, you snatch it and eat it. The other species eats secretions of trees. So they sit beside the tree, wait, for the gum to come out. And the gum comes out and they take it slowly. And what does this have to do with what we're speaking about? Or the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Our ability, what this experiment is saying, our ability to be patient has to do with our eating habits even. Our eating habits. Why am I not patient when calamities happen? How do you eat? What? Oh yeah. Remember, eating habits, what is something I train myself for. Every day. Every day I'm eating three times a day that way. Snatching, snatching, snatching. I'm developing the nafs, if you will. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is the center of what I'm speaking about today. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he said, "Man yasbir, yusabbirhu Allah. Wa ma u'tiya ahadun ata'an khayran wa la awsa' min as-sabr." Whoever exercises and tries to be patient, Allah will change him and will make him patient. And nobody is given something, a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that's vaster or better than patience. Look, scholars say based on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الحلم بالتحلم والصبر بالتصبر والعلم بالتعلم. You want patience, you exercise for it. What I'm speaking about today is something that will be strange for you, you might have not even heard. Riyadatul Nafs, spiritual exercise. If I was to begin this khutbah and say, today we'll be going to speaking about the importance of exercising. You think about what? The gym. Well, yeah, riyadah, gym, for the body. But scholars identified something else. Inside of me, patience, for example, is a muscle. I need to exercise to develop the muscles of patience. The problem is when we don't exercise. And therefore, what I'm asking you today, this riyadat al-nafs, spiritual exercise, a set of exercises that you do regularly, to develop intentionally the muscles of patience. So when I need it, it's there. When we want to develop the muscles of our bodies, what do? We go to the gym. And we do what? Do you go one time? Two times? You go regularly. And what we do there? We sweat. We carry weights. Right? Similarly, I'm speaking about mujahadat al-nafs, struggling against the nafs. Those spiritual exercises are similarly. And that's what I started with, remember? Why am I not patient? How can I be more patient? There are exercises. And can I tell you something? Unfortunately, something that I see nowadays, and this is why I'm speaking today, our kids, this age, is actually causing us to be the opposite. Our environment outside is training us not to be patient. Think about it. Think about it. You go outside, video games. Training us for what? Computers. You sit in front of the computer, you open five windows at the same time. You click, you have to do 100 megabit per second, right? Quickly. The way we speak, we have to speak fast. Look at how I'm speaking in this khutbah. Oh, I have a lot to say. 15 minutes left. They need to go to their work. What if I was to speak slowly and lower my rate? Will you be patient? This is tranquility. This is the way we should speak, especially when we speak about Allah. What if I continue the khutbah that way? Yes, you'll sleep. See, I have to be fast, have to be quick, right? Internet age, 100 megabit per second. Our environment is training us not to be patient. The way we move, the way we eat, our computers, our technology, if you look carefully, our kids, for God's sake, they're going to have a bigger problem. I'm not against technology, but technology, the computers were meant to serve us. You know what's happening now? The computers are programming us. I sit in front of my computer at work, I open 4 windows, they give me 2 screens. Why? Well, you have to do many things at the same time. 10 things at the same time. I know. Young guys understand very well what I'm saying. You open a Word document, you're surfing the internet, you're speaking to your friend, and the cadence so I can design my circuit in the same time, right? And multiple sessions, and I'm working this way. Focused on 3-4 things, my mind is everywhere. And then, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, it's time to pray. Okay, I go, right? And look what I do. I leave my computer. I go to the other office. Allahu Akbar. I'm supposed to do what now? Focus? I'm supposed to think about one? I have been trained. I have been trained for hours not to be able to be patient for 5 minutes and focus on one thing. It affects me. And therefore, a spiritual exercise, I can tell you, I know it's annoying, do the opposite. In the past, one of them had a servant that was annoying and not responding well to him. And people said, why don't you change that servant? And he said the following. I'm using him to train myself for patience. He's my mentor. The computer, can I tell you something? Spiritual exercise to do. Go and install a program in your computer. It's called Time Out Free. Those who have an Apple, or go and download this app. What does it do? You install it on your computer. Every now and then while you're working, it will freeze your computer. Tell you, please wait. And when you do that, you know what I would tell you? Be in dhikr. I can't, I'll be very angry. When I drive back from work, from that environment, I go back, I'm driving 75 miles per hour. Why? Drive 60 miles. No, I can't be patient. See? I can't slow down. You know why we're not patient? Slow down. Slow down your life. Slower. The way we speak, the way we drive. I go back, I park my car, immediately I go out. I slap the door, and I how do I even walk to my work or my house? Fast! Can I tell you an exercise that's necessary to learn patience? You drive, you reach your work, you reach your house. You know what you do? You turn off the car, you turn off the radio, you turn off everything. Stay in the car for 5 minutes. Doing what? Doing nothing. What? See, I'm not used to that. My mind can't take this. What do you mean? As a matter of fact, the only way to rest my mind nowadays is what? Is to go to the TV, open it, and watch an action movie. I don't know if you get what... You see what our environment is doing to us? We're not conscious. Slow down. Just sit in the car for 5 minutes. Do what? Clear your mind. Think of Allah. Pause. Slow down. When you walk out of the car, don't walk fast. Intentionally, move slowly. That's hilm. That's the enni. Can I do this? This is a spiritual exercise. The way we speak, we suffer nowadays. Look at Egyptians. I'm from Egypt. I don't need to comment. Just ask an Egyptian, what do you think about Morsi? Watch what will happen. Hassan, what's your opinion about what's going on in Egypt? Whatever I say here is not going to change it. But if I tell you my opinion, I know what's going to do to this community. And right? You know what I'm speaking about. So I want you to do this as a spiritual exercise, especially Egyptians. You go and tell someone, so what's your opinion about what's going on in Egypt? He starts speaking. You know what you do? What do? We interrupt. Do you interrupt people when they speak? Lack of patience. I can't be, come on, hurry up. Sometimes I finish the sentence for them. They're speaking too slowly. You know what I'm doing? I'm upping up the rate. Come on, guys, speed up. So he competes, we speed up. I want you to do the following. What is your opinion about what's going on in Egypt? Let him speak. Give him the mic. 20 minutes, 30 minutes. And you know what? Resist your temptation. Don't tell him your opinion. And when he's done, hug him. Tell him, Jazakumullah khair, I'll think about it, and change the topic. I can never do this. Because, and of course, I have excuses. الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر, right? Well, there are conditions for it. And if I'm agitated, I'll cause more damage. Egyptians, لساني كالعقرب إن تركته لدغني. My tongue is like a scorpion. If I don't restrain it, it stings me. It harms me. How much do we need that? Facebook included. Hold back, restrain. There is another day. I'll tell you. You want my opinion on Egypt? I can tell you. Not this time, next month. Yeah, I'm not joking. Let's be patient. That's what Sheikh Yasser, I discussed this concept with him, even regarding khawatir, thoughts. And he told me, yes, you want to understand how difficult it is and why we suffer because of the lack of patience? Go to someone and tell him the following. Try, and I know, like, please don't try it. It's very cruel. So I come to one of our brothers here, and I tell him the following. Brother, I know you. MashaAllah, I know you now for 2 years. You're such a good person, but you know there is something I need to tell you, but I don't know if, yani, I hope you don't get offended. Yani, please, I don't know if I should tell you or not. As a matter of fact, let me not tell you. And I'll walk back home. What happens to him? You see, some sisters are smiling now because, oh yeah, I can use that. Right? I can use it against my husband. I can, you know what's... A trained person, a person who's patient, you know what he'll respond with? Okay, Hassan, whenever you're ready to tell me, tell me. And I'll switch my mind off. Most of us, I'll leave, I'll go home. You're going to go home thinking what? What did he mean? What was it? My mind is going to kill me. Can I tell you something? They call it khawatir. Thoughts. Lack of controlling our thoughts. We suffer in this life because of lack of patience. You know how? Anxiety and sadness. What is anxiety? I tell my mind there is a problem in the future. I lost my job. Who's going to pay my bills? I don't know. Go think about it. That's what you tell your mind. Your mind goes, analyzes the analytical mode, analyze, comes back. I don't know. What do you mean you don't know? Find the solution. And you know what happens? It is not haram to plan. But I should have the ability to say, it's the time for the khutbah. I should not be planning. I'm with my kids. I should not be planning. It's not, I'll plan later. But you know what happens to most of us? Anxiety is when my mind lives in the future and cannot come back now. I can't. I was not trained for that. My mind lives in the past. He did this last year. And I remember very well what he did. And I keep what? I go back home. I keep thinking about it. I relive it. It causes me pain. Well, it happened last year. It's not the time to think about it. I can't let go. My mind is always there. Allahu Akbar, it goes back. Allahu Akbar, it goes forward. It's like having a time machine. I'm never in the present. Can I restrain my mind? We lack patience. We need spiritual exercises to develop patience. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Slowing down is a very important aspect. In our work, with our computers, video games, we need to slow down. See, they say, life is short. Therefore, we all need to move slower. It's short. Why are you running? Really, life is short. And we need to, the things I'm saying, those concepts of spiritual exercises, I have 15 of them to attain patience. Spiritual things that we can do. Some are from the deen, some are secular. To develop the muscles of patience. Some of us would say, that is too hard. That is exactly mujahadat al-nafs. That's exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in the Quran. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. The one that is afraid from the station of his Lord and ends up going against himself, mujahadat al-nafs. Some of us say, it's a poem, subhanAllah, wonderful poem, when the author says the following, I'm amazed at the seeker of purity, who complains when the time of polishing comes. Son, when the rug is being beaten, the beating is not directed against the rug. The beating is directed against the dirt in the rug. Son, the harsh treatment is not directed against you. It is directed against the dirt in you. I have a nafs inside. I need to work against it. And there are many ways. I leave you with two things from our deen to do. Spiritual exercises for patience. Two things. One, I can't lower my gaze. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to do? Fast, right? You know what's the answer? Brother, I tried that. It doesn't help. I fast. What does fasting do, by the way? If you contemplate with what, it's going against the self. I want to eat. No. I want to have legitimate relations. No. Restrain. Delay. It's not Maghrib yet. Learn to pause. Learn to postpone. Right? But it's not working. Can I tell you why? Here is a very simple way. Why? I'll tell you what happens. I fast. In Ramadan even. I fast what? In Ramadan, alhamdulillah, we fasted what? 16 hours? Right? You know what? 16 hours fast. So I'm fasting and I'm holding back myself. Don't eat. Don't eat. Don't eat. Good. You're developing the muscle now. What happens at the time of iftar? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, adhan of Maghrib. See, some of you are smiling because you know what happens. I let go. Here are the food and the nafs is, you made me fast for 16 hours, right? You will see what I'll do. And I break my fast with vengeance. It's like a person who eats healthy in the morning, goes to the gym, and after that ends up, you know what I mean, eating junk for the rest of the day. So you supported the heart and then you supported the nafs. It's not, so they tell you, you want to do it properly, you want to lower your gaze, that's what you do, fast. When it's the time of breaking the fast, that is one of the most important times in fasting. So what do you do? Go to the masjid, for example. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, not time to eat yet. Break the fast with maybe one or two, 3 dates. Drink some water and then pray Salat al-Maghrib. After prayers, let's go eat. No, 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 I'm going to sit there, do dhikr. After dhikr, now let's go eat. Yeah, 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 and here is how you do it. I want you to fast Mondays and Thursdays, or Mondays only if you want, and I want you to break your fast with water, milk, and dates only. What? No other thing. That's not healthy. You're not going to die from one day. That's a prophetic thing. What do you mean? I restrain myself. I'm going today, I'm eating only dates and water and milk. That's it. Nothing else. That's too difficult. Okay, I'll tell you something easier. Go ahead in the masjid. Oh, they have this long open buffet, you know, biryani and ruz bil laban and everything, right? Go and stand at the end of the line. And then when it's time to eat, you look to the food. Which food I like the most? Biryani. That's the one I'm not going to eat. This mujahadat al-nafs. I go to a restaurant. Here is the menu. What is my first choice? I'm going to skip it. Take the second choice. That mujahadat al-taskeen, right? A final point that's in the Quran and is one of the most important. Dhikr. Mentioned in so many verses in the Quran. Patience has everything to do with dhikr. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلِ الْغُرُوبِ. And many verses that way. Have patience, telling the Prophet about what they say about you. You need patience. How? Be in consistent state of dhikr, in tasbih, before the sun comes and after it comes. And as a matter of fact, even this verse that I'm going to tell you is what Salahuddin used to train his army. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً فَاذْبُتُوا وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who believe, if you are at war, the battlefield, and you face a position, an enemy, be consistently in dhikr a lot. Lots of dhikr in the battlefield. That causes you to be steadfast and attain success. Dhikr, dhikr, the ability to be in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? What does it have to do? And I'll finish with this. I'll tell you, very simple. Look at it. Look at the interesting pattern. Allah did not leave it to us. There is 5 times a day where we have to do salah. What is it? It's training. I'm working, working, working with my kids, and then all of a sudden, Allahu Akbar. What does that mean? Allahu Akbar. God is greater. I'm teaching my mind, restrain, refrain, drop it. I'm thinking about my work. Allahu Akbar. I'm teaching my mind to drop. Go. Focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can restrain my mind 5 times a day. It's training. After salah, what am I supposed to do? We finish salah, we're going to pray. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Up to my car to go to work. What is the sunnah? Stay in your position. Right there. Don't even move. For how long? Just give me 5 minutes. What are you going to do? What the Prophet told us. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. You know. Allah, the adhkar. 33. Do I do it? What do I, myself? Allahu Akbar. I finish salah. Salamu alaykum. Salamu alaykum. And my nafs tells me what? Go. 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 Don't sit. That is exactly why I have to train myself. I need to be patient. I'll sit and for 5 minutes I'll do dhikr. regularly 5 times a day. That's training. I can refrain, I can pause, it can wait. And then when I do dhikr, how do I do it? Subhanallah, 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 subhanallah. No, I want you to do dhikr. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Try it. Wallahi, like try it and you will see, I'll discover myself when I do that. You'll find in the beginning, I can't wait. It looks like the end of the world. We're not trained. And my mind will kill me. My mind is not used to have a free time, not to think about anything. You're restraining me to think about one? Impossible. That's why we suffer. Our mind is everywhere. Uncontrollable. And that's the introduction of what we call watchfulness, not mindfulness. Mindfulness is good. We in Islam have something called watchfulness, muraqaba. To watch my thoughts. To be able, this thought is not good, refrain. I'm thinking, I'm watchful, I'm present with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr is being present with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr is about that. I do it properly. Can you do 5 minutes, 10 minutes, adhkar al-sabah, adhkar al-masa, every day? And I sit and I tell you practical thing. I cannot focus, it's so hard. They tell you, therefore, do the following. You do something physical. Write the dhikr in the air. Allahu Akbar, for example. Think about the letters. Write it. Allahu Akbar. Allah. What am I doing? But I'm not thinking about the meaning. I know. But I'm restraining my mind to think about what? One thing. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. For just 5 minutes. And watch the ability that you develop after that. Dhikr improves my irada, my willpower, my ability to restrain. Finally, I'll leave you with this. There is everything to do. Patience. Why am I not patient when calamities happen? Right? My ability to be patient in front of calamities has everything to do with me exercising patience in the time of ease. If I am one that focuses regularly on dhikr in the time of ease, when calamities happen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes me patient. تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the times of ease. Exercise. Don't wait. And He will know you in the time of difficulty. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان وجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين اللهم ارزقنا الرضا اللهم إنا نسألك نفسا مطمئنة ترضى بعطائك وتقنع بعطائك وترجو لقائك اللهم يا رب العالمين يا واحد يا أحد يا فرد يا صمد يا من لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد اللهم رد أمة محمد إلى لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي